Welcome to Hodgepodge Australia. Continuing with our Disney theme, we're putting Belle in a buttercream ball dress. You are going to want a Wilton doll cake and a Belle doll, preferably with a plastic top because it just saves you having to make a top out of buttercream. Wrap her legs in glad wrap and then layer your doll cake. Now with the Wilton dog pans, or really any of the doll pans I'm assuming, they never seem to come out the same height as the dolls because everybody uses real dolls these days and not the dolls with just the head on them and a toothpick that you can stick into the cake, which would make more sense. But if you want a customized doll, you've got to use the doll. And I'm rambling, but let's carry on with it. The doll cake never actually comes out to the right height of the doll. There is always a gap between the cake and the doll's waist, and you need to chop that up somehow. Now you have a couple of options of what you can do. You can either bake another cake to put below your doll cake and turn it into a platform, like you can see here I've done with my Anna cake. And if you want to see that video, you can either click the photo or see the description box below, or you can take a piece of fondant and you can top up that gap between the cake and the waist by just wrapping a nice big rectangle around your cake so that you can build the buttercream up onto your doll. So I'm going to pop that on there and then it is time to decorate with the buttercream. I'm using white buttercream with a rose tip on it because I'm going to put a couple of frills in just to break up the cake a bit. So just starting with a triangle, I'm just going to swerve it either way. And actually, if you shake the buttercream tip as you're putting it on there, you can see you get a lot more of a ruffle effect rather than just going straight across. And this sort of looks like the underneath of her dress. You know, you have all those petticoats on those beautiful fairy tale princess dresses. So this is sort of the effect of her petticoat underline. Then getting your yellow buttercream again with a petal tip, it's time to do some ruffles. So just add a few ruffles down the sides of your white petticoat buttercream section just to cover up any gaps. Pop that on either side so you have a nice triangle, and then we will add in some frills. Pop the largest part of your petal tip into the side of the cake. So you want to have, if that makes any sort of sense, you want the large end of that teardrop petal tip to be the closest part of the cake. And then you are just simply going to do these ruffles all the way around from one triangle to the other, all the way up the cake, and there you have a beautiful ball gown for Belle. Just to add on a little bit of accent, I've just got a smaller little star tip, and using the yellow buttercream, I'm just going to add in some flowers onto her dress, just to break it up a bit, because it's a lot of yellow. So just a little bit of accent onto her dress. You could always add another color on there if you want, or if you want to cut out some fondant flowers and stick them on there, that would be lovely too, or some bows, but I've gone with nice star tip rose. So just adding on some different sizes of them around her dress where I feel like they need to go, and it's also good for covering up any holes that you might have made with your petals if it hasn't quite covered. And just to really bring them out, I'm using some silver balls to highlight the flowers. And there is your Beauty and the Beast Belle buttercream ball gown cake for our Disney themed month. I do hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure you check out our other videos, hit that like button, subscribe to us, and we'll see you again real soon.